solid ground, like a rock. We like to think of the Earth as being stable under our feet, but that's not always true, is it? It's right there in the name, Earthquake. On a regular day, the Earth won't start randomly shaking under you at any moment, but it does happen. There are mighty forces at work beneath Earth's surface that can cause the Earth to, well, shake. Imagine a cell phone buzzing from a call or text. Earthquakes are sort of like this, but instead of a cell phone, it's the Earth that's buzzing. It only takes a little motor to make your phone move. Just think how big the forces have to be to move the Earth. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. Simply put, an earthquake is when the Earth quakes. But do we know why? Do we know how? An earthquake is like a sudden jolt or shaking of the ground that happens when the Earth's surface moves unexpectedly. This shaking is caused by energy that builds up inside the Earth. Imagine the Earth is like a giant jigsaw puzzle, and each piece of the puzzle is what we call a tectonic plate. These plates are constantly moving, but sometimes they get stuck or bump into each other. When these tectonic plates suddenly break free, it releases energy and causes the ground to shake. To understand how this happens, let's start with the structure of the Earth. Imagine the Earth was a giant peach with several layers. The outermost layer, where we live, is called the crust. It's like the skin of the peach, thin and solid. Right beneath the crust is the mantle. Think of it as the flesh of the peach, just less juicy and delicious. The mantle is much thicker than the crust and is made up of semi-solid rock that can flow very slowly. Deep inside the Earth is the outer core, which is actually liquid. It's like a sea of molten metal swirling around the solid inner core, which is the very center of the Earth, similar to the peach pit. The inner core is super hot and made of solid metal because the pressure there is incredibly high. Another way to think about pressure building up is there's a lot of energy pent up inside the Earth. We've talked about this before in our video about volcanic eruptions. Find the link below. But releasing pent-up energy is also an important idea for earthquakes. Earthquakes start in the crust, often close to where the edges of different tectonic plates meet, but the shaking can be strong enough to travel through all these layers and be felt on the surface. What do we mean by strong? Do we have a way to talk about the strength of earthquakes? Yes. Earthquakes are measured using two main scales, the Richter scale and the moment magnitude scale. The Richter scale was developed first and uses a number to describe the size of an earthquake based on the energy released. It's like a thermometer for earthquakes, but instead of measuring temperature, it measures how strong the biggest jolt is during a quake. The scale starts at 0, which would hardly be felt, and can go beyond 10 for extremely powerful earthquakes, although these are very rare. These number ratings are called magnitudes. So you could say an earthquake has a magnitude of 5. One important thing to keep in mind is that the Richter scale is a logarithmic scale. This is an idea you'll learn about in math, where going up 1 point on the Richter scale actually stands for an earthquake that is 10 times more powerful. So if you think an earthquake with magnitude 5 is no big deal, a magnitude 6 is 10 times stronger. Yikes. The moment magnitude scale is a more modern and detailed method that also measures the energy of an earthquake, but it can give a clearer picture of the quake's true size, especially for very large quakes. It takes more information into account, like how big of an area is involved and the distance the ground moved. Both scales help scientists understand and compare different earthquakes. To actually measure earthquakes, scientists use tools called seismographs. A seismograph records the vibrations in the ground. When an earthquake happens, it sends out waves that travel through the Earth, and these waves shake the seismograph. It has a pen that stays still while the ground and paper under it shake during an earthquake, drawing squiggly lines that show the vibrations. The bigger the squiggles, the stronger the earthquake. This information helps scientists figure out not only how strong an earthquake is, but also where it started and how deep it was within the Earth's crust. Want to take home a souvenir of these natural wonders? Visit our website for smart fun posters that are funny and fact-filled. Find the link below. Can you remember any big earthquakes? Throughout history, there have been many that we still talk about today. One of the most famous is the 1906 San Francisco earthquake in the United States, which had a magnitude of about 7.9. This massive quake caused a ton of destruction to the city of San Francisco, with buildings crumbling and fires that burned for days. Another notable earthquake was in 2011 in Japan, known as the Great East Japan Earthquake. It was one of the strongest ever recorded, with a magnitude of 9.0. This earthquake triggered a huge tsunami, waves as high as 40 meters, which caused lots of damage to coastal towns. These earthquakes show how powerful and destructive nature can be. We can wonder at the epic power of nature, because remember, this is all out of our hands. We're not causing these disasters, but that doesn't mean we're completely helpless. There are a few things that we can do to help limit the destruction and improve safety when earthquakes do happen. Engineers work like superhero designers to make sure buildings can stand strong during earthquakes. One way to prevent buildings from falling down is to put big shock absorbers under buildings. Shock absorbers are sort of like giant springs. These springs help the building sway back and forth gently when an earthquake shakes the ground, instead of cracking or falling over. They also use special materials that can bend without breaking, kind of like how a flexible straw bends without snapping. This way, the buildings can wiggle a little when the earth moves, but stay safe and whole. Plus, engineers make sure the base of a building is super strong and grippy, so it doesn't slide around during a quake. Or, they can even do the complete opposite, and put the whole building on sliders or rollers so they can move back and forth during a quake without snapping. All these smart designs help keep everyone inside the building safe when the earth does decide to dance. But what should you do if an earthquake ever hits? Before an earthquake, it's smart to make sure heavy items in your home, like bookshelves and TV stands, are securely fastened to the walls so they won't tip over. Have an emergency kit ready with items like water, snacks, a flashlight, and a first aid kit. During an earthquake, if you're indoors, stay there. And remember to drop, cover, and hold on. Drop to the floor, take cover under a sturdy piece of furniture, like a table or desk, and hold on until the shaking stops. Stay away from windows to avoid broken glass. If you're outdoors, stay in open areas away from buildings, trees, streetlights, and utility wires. After the shaking stops, check yourself and others for injuries and move carefully to avoid debris or damaged areas. Listen to the radio or check online for official information and instructions. These steps can help you stay calm and safe during and after an earthquake. As we've seen today, earthquakes really know how to shake things up. And now you know more about how and why the Earth rumbles from time to time. Even more importantly, don't forget the important strategies for staying safe before, during, and after an earthquake. By staying educated and ready, you can face these natural events with confidence and courage. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.